Noriega against Yelich. They played earlier this year, and Noriega clearly held their own against Yelich. Chris?
So far, the Americans doing a nice job on Yelich. And Noriega looks great. First two matches, a little sluggish coming out of the barrel, but maybe tonight she knew she was going to get to start warmed up harder. She's got some gas.
Well, particularly if you've had success in a matchup or against a particular opponent, you come out very ready, have a clear picture in your mind of what you can do successfully if she already has three kills. And Bill Walton continuing that point about what to do against Barbara Yelich. Assistant coach Toshi Yoshida said, when I said to him, what's the key against her? He said, from the left side, she loves to crank the ball hard cross court. If we can just slow that down, block a few with Danielle Scott, dig a few, we can take some of her confidence.
Cross battle, and a nice set by Robin Amo. So far, the United States passing has been solid with the exception of the one Logan Tom Shank. Now, Danielle Scott, car cross battle in the front line, two former Long Beach State 49ers. Noriega serving. First set, Americans up by two. Up by three now, and Scott.
A gentle tap down. You got to bash that ball into the floor.
Or take someone's head off.
Well, isn't that bashing? You don't consider that bashing?
Well, not into the floor. Just take a whack at it.
It would just be like you. Rather than just go for the kill, you'd aim at somebody's face.
There you go. The Americans serve out again. A second service error for Noriega.
That's okay. I'll take a few. You got to serve tough. Croatia's serve reception. When we get a look at it again, you'll see us playing very shallow. You have to move them back and try to break them up a little bit.
Yelich, bad pass over the net. Chance for an earned point. Shea Pukina is blocked. And Amo, what is she doing? She tipped it out of bounds. Thought she saw a footy pad and missed it.
Talk to your middle blocker, Danielle Scott. Set a little ball in the middle, but don't do that. That was not a good play, obviously. And you know what? Women do not jump serve all that often. We'll see the Russians, they jump serve a lot. But the Americans must adjust. And what's hurting them, I think the Americans in practice, Kerry Walsh, their best jump server, isn't in practice hitting balls at the American serve reception because of the injury.
The GM U.S. Olympic countdown.
A great job on the two big guns for Croatia. Barbie Yelich, number eight, and Natasha Leto, number one. And Leto bounces another one out. So both the big hitters for Croatia. Frustrated ball.
And Danielle Scott reaching, even with that broken ring finger on her left hand, far into the cross court. And Leto forced to hit the ball sharper and sharper and lower that one off the top of the tape and out of bounds.
United States on a 4-0 run down the line. Great dig by Tara Cross Battle. She does that well. And the Americans unable to get a swing. Set left, here comes Leto. And Leto puts it away. You're not going to stop her for long. Coming into this match, she got 63 sets. Had 33 kills, 52% kill percent. He's lethal.
And good adjustment by Leto. You don't want to mess around with Danielle Scott, the top blocker in the Olympics so far in the early going. She turned that off of Robin Amo.
Danielle Scott is dug. Set left. Here goes Leto again, and Leto puts it away. She's hitting right in the seam in between the tall Danielle Scott at 6'3", and the short Robin Amo. At 5'10".
But if you're a small blocker, you don't want to reach up. Just press and take an area. You play defense as a team. Sometimes a blocker gets a little bit desperate, reaches up, and it's easy to hit the ball down and through. Set a good block and let the defense dig around.
Logan Tom off to a good start. Three kills for head coach Mick Haley.
Like the way she moves the ball around, Chris. Uses the outside blocker, tips periodically, changes speed, and she does have the hard crank cross court.
Al 8-point scoring, first four sets to 25, best three out of five. Here comes Yelich. He's blocked again. And nobody home covering. Not one Croat moves to react, and Yelich is steaming. They'll set her again right here.
Well, and hitting out of the backcourt right now against Logan Tom, Heather Bone on the left side if she hits out of the D zone.
Watch for the 8 train coming again if they get it to her. No, bad pass. Free ball, United States looking for 22. Little trick play, Logan Tom came in, back set, and a rejection, Elena Chebukina. Chebukina knows what she's doing. A gold and a silver medal. She said she wants to get the bronze to complete the set.
Well, a lot like Andrea Gardini last night for Italy. Now, 35 years of age, doesn't jump the way he used to, still moves very well, and knows how to block. Gets his hands over.
Leto on the left, and she hits it into the bottom of the net.
One of the things that the Americans are doing with their serving is they're going after Leto to try to take her out of the play so that then, even though Yelich is getting most of the sets, it's even more predictable so the Americans can really set their defense.
Robin Amo serving. She has played very well in the Olympics so far. Here comes Yelich. And Yelich is done. Noriega got it. Set left, Logan Tom. And Tom spikes it down. First set, United States leading Croatia by 6. Americans playing flawlessly so far, and they are blocking. Leto, stop. And that ball is going down. How many blocks, Mike Sondheimer? 6 for the Americans in the first set.
And the United States, particularly Sarah Noriega, has just got Leto completely. Don't let her out of the closet.
Set point for the United States, Robin Amo. And they're working on Leto, as Paul Sunderland suggested. Here comes Yelich. And Yelich. Cross battle is there. Of course, Cross battle is a fantastic defensive player, number 13 in red. Amazing defender.
This set is over. What the United States has to do is not let Croatia get any momentum. They need to end this set right here, scoring with their offense.
Another perfect pass. Noriega whacks it. Croatia has it. Croatia can get a point. They set Leto. And Leto.
Called it out, but the referee has changed that around by indicating a touch on
that
American block. And it was in by the way. That's a way of getting by it without showing up the line.
Second set point for the United States. They put the ball down, it's over. Set left side, Logan Thomas is hot. And so far, Croatia. Number 10, the youngster, Grigorovic. No answer for Logan Thomas. First set. Mick Haley's game plan working perfectly so far. The United States in charge against Croatia. Perhaps the key, he told his women not to talk to the media, particularly Sunderland, Marlowe, and Walton, and to focus on this match.
That's always a good prescription for success.
I can see him telling you and Walton to stay away, but what about me?
What about you?
What about me? 16-9. Second set, the United States. Playing beautiful volleyball. They're passing, they're setting, they're putting the ball away, their block is in the right spot.
Heather Bone
serving strategically.
And Heather Bone very much has joined the party offensively and blocking. Got a couple of stuffs against Yelich and a couple of nice kills as well off the pitch from Robin Amo.
Gank pass. Here comes cross foul. She tips right into the defense. Grigorovic has it up. Here comes Yelich. And Yelich just blocked again. And she's on her back.
And if you're Tara Cross battle and don't like the look of a particular set, why not tip? Because you've got a three-woman block happening up here. And this time, Sarah Noriega, along with Danielle Scott, put Yelich, not down for the count, but certainly down.
7 kills for Yelich. However, she has 6 errors in 20 attempts. Those are very, very bad numbers for the world's number one hitter. Now Yelich will serve. Got a big jumper. Amo saves it to Danielle Scott.
That's a wonderful set by Robin Amo. You look at her ability to get up there and set that ball at only 5-9, because that pass was headed for trouble off the jump serve from Barbara Yelich. Important for the United States to get her off the service line. First time, every time.
18-11, Kay Pukana with the flag. I asked Yelena Kay Pukana, where do you keep your medals? She said, in my house. I look at them every once in a while. They make me feel very, very good. She has a gold and a silver. Logan Tom tip. Here comes Yelich, tip.
Good nice shot. Smart shot. The United States, you know, they all scout one another. And the United States, when the ball is set to the D zone out of the right back, has Robin Amo rotate under the block. So that leaves the area. Look at Robin Amo. She's a right front player. She vacates. Barbara Yelich knows from the scouting report that that's available.
Danielle Scott thunders it through. Scott, a part-time starter in Atlanta, has grown into one of the great players in the world. You have to say Regla Torres is the best middle blocker in the world, but Danielle Scott not far behind.
I talked to Mick Haley after the impressive first evening win against China, and he said, Paul, Danielle Scott has been playing overseas and in Brazil. People don't see her in the United States as often as they should, but she is absolutely all world. She's been leading us. Sometimes we get off to a slow start, but she's been carrying us, particularly blocking.
Yelena Trebukhina.